Well, we started quite a few months, weeks or months ago in Hebrews chapter 11, and that whole chapter talks about the strong champions of faith. And we started out that faith, without faith is impossible to please God. And one of my favorite characters in the Bible is Joseph. And I picked Joseph, and I want you to turn to, with me to Hebrews chapter 11, verse 22. It says, by faith, Joseph, when he was at his end, near his end, spoke about the exit of the Israelites from Egypt and gave instruction concerning the burial of his bones. So here Joseph knows that they're going to go out, but he's at the end of his days, and he tells the Israelites what they're going to do. He gives instructions what to do with his bones. Joseph at that time was a prime minister. He was in his youth. He had power, he had wealth, and out of, you know, the blue, just he talks to his brothers and to his people, and he says, you're going to leave from here. You're going to go, but remember, I'm going to give you instruction what to do with my bones. So the title of my message tonight is The Faith of Joseph. You know, we as human beings are the only creatures that know that we die and we expired. And we're so afraid of that. And if you see and you watch TV, we do everything we can to avoid that. Plastic surgery, makeup. You see the man in his 60s wearing a gold chain and, you know, driving a sports car. We try to avoid that. And why is that? Well, Satan knows that if he can have us in bondage and the fear of debt, we're in his bondage. And in Hebrews 2:14, Hebrews 2:14 and 15 is talks about Jesus' debt and says, since the children have flesh and blood, he too shared in that in their humanity, so that they, by his debt he might break the power of him who holds the power of death, that this, the devil, and free those who all their lives were held in slavery by the fear of debt. So what he's talking about here is Jesus came through his debt to free us of that bondage. A pastor said one time that a person will never feel like he's living until he no longer is afraid of death. And I think Joseph, when he was speaking to his brothers, he knew he was dying. He was 110 years old. He knew what, you know, what was going to happen to him. So he was explaining to them, you know what? I know the promises that God gave to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And what I'm talking about here is the faith of Joseph. How can he be so sure to say what he was saying to his brothers and be so sure of that? That's because he saturated himself with the word. He read the scriptures. He read the scrolls. And 300 years before that, God promised Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob that you will be in a land where you will be slaves for 400 years, but I will bring you out. And that's where Joseph was basing his faith on. A few thoughts that I want to share with you, and I want to turn with you to Genesis chapter 50, verse 22 and 26. It says that Joseph stayed in Egypt along with all his fathers and family. He lived 110 years and saw his third generation of Ephraim's children and also the children of Manasseh, son of Manasseh, were placed on at birth on Joseph's knee. Then Joseph said to his brother, I'm about to die, but God will surely come to you in aid and take you up out of this land to the land that was promised to by oath to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And Joseph made the Israelites swear an oath and said, God will surely come to you in aid, and then you must carry my bones up from this place. So Joseph died at the age of 110, and after they embalmed him and placed him in a tomb in Egypt. This is Genesis 22:26. So the key verse here is Joseph, in verse 24, said to his brother, I'm about to die, but you will surely come out. And when you do, make sure that you take my bones with you. How did Joseph, you know, have that confidence? Well, when you base your faith on the scripture, what Joseph did is he looked back to the promises of God to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He didn't just bring it out of himself. He looked at the scriptures. He said, you know what? God promised to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We will be here. We will be here. This was 300 years later. He was 110, so he knew. And you know what? What he said is very key, because he said, don't carry my body with you, but carry my bones. Meaning he knew, he understood that there was still some time left to pass. He spoke in faith, and that's the faith that I want to talk to you about. What is it based on? So no wonder that Joseph, 300 years after, you know, the promise that was given to Abraham, he was able to be so confident in what he was saying to his brothers and encouraging them. The scripture that I always refer to, it says that, what is faith? Because on one side, the scripture says that without faith, it is impossible to please God. So I want us to understand, what is faith? It says that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. That's the key. Faith comes by hearing. And what do we hear? We have to hear the word of God. We can't. Faith is not positive thinking. Faith is not following a hunch or hoping for the best or feelings or sensations or optimism. Self is not self-confidence or wishing, crossing your fingers and hoping. But faith is getting a promise from the word of God and standing on it. Remember, in Hebrews 1, it says that without faith, it is impossible. Now, faith is the something of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. I'm going to read this verse in three different translations. And I know the Romanian only has two translations, but I'm able to go into three different translations. The King James says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. The New Living Translation says, faith is the confidence that what we hope for will actually happen. Gives us the assurance about things we cannot see. So actually what we can hope for and know that it will happen gives us the assurance that it will. The other translation is the NIV, New Living Translation. Now faith is confident in what we hope for and assured about what we do not see. In Hebrew 1, so three translations. Now what is hope? Hope in the Bible is not like, you know, what we do when a girl meets a guy and, you know, she hopes that they'll get married. That's not what the Bible means when it says hope. Hope means that the glorious assurance based on the word of God and a promise from the word of God. It's not something, like I said earlier, it's not a wish. It's not something you just, you know, talk to yourself. It's based on the word of God. That's how we receive hope. The second coming is called the blessed hope. How do we know that Jesus is coming back? The word of God. How do we receive faith? With hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Again, I'm talking about Joseph's faith. What did he do? He went back 300 years at the promise of God to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That's where he drew the strength. That's where he found the faith. Well, I don't know if it was on a piece of leather, on a scroll, on the scripture. He read it. He poured it all over himself. He read it. He saturated himself with the word of God. Now, if you go back in the history of the church, there was a pastor, an evangelist called Dwight L. Moody. And if you study, the history of the church, you'll definitely come across him. He was a very illiterate man, very poor, uneducated. But he took two continents and shook them for God. And one time he came to prayer, and he kept praying. He said, God, give me faith. I want faith. I want more faith. And he finally realized, it's not happening. But you know what? He came across the scripture in Romans 10:17 that says, so then by faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. He got a hold of that scripture, and he kept reading it, and he kept reading it, and he kept reading it. And you know what happened? He received faith. He could pray all day long, and he finally realized, you know what? This is the key. In Romans 10:17, it says, so that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So faith is the byproduct of hearing the word of God. You cannot have faith if you are just merely, you know, guessing at it, guessing that God wants this from you or God wants that. And, when you say, God said it in his word. God said it in Genesis 8, I will establish my covenant with you. In Genesis 7:4, 7 days from now, I will send the rain. Genesis 12:2, I will make you a great nation. I will bless you. That is the word of God. That's how we receive faith. Young generation, young youth, this was your weekend. It's awesome to see you guys praise. I had an amazing time last night worshiping with you. But you know what? When you leave this and you leave the presence of God and you leave worship, the only thing that will sustain you and the only thing that you can go back to is the word of God. You're not here to have music, to have band. But you know what? If you saturate yourself, just like Joseph did, where did he go? He didn't go anywhere else but back to the promise of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob 300 years before he spoke it. And it was still 100 and some years after that the Israelites went out of Egypt. That's where you will find faith. When you're struggling at school with decisions you make, it says, the word of God says, in the multitudes of a company of multitudes of people, you get wisdom. Seek out your friends. Seek out people that love you when you need to make a decision. Exodus 2, God says, I will be with you. I will heal you. I will never forsake you. We cannot base our faith once we leave this building on just feelings. It can't. It will, feelings and sensations will deceive you. But the word of God will never deceive you. Faith is resting in the unbreakable promises of God. Take that and understand that when you go, I struggle with that. I'm not here telling you something that I don't struggle with. We all do. But when we saturate ourselves with the word of God and the word of God is in us, then you don't doubt. I know a lot of you young people struggle. What is the will of God? Seek the word of God. And God will reveal himself and God will reveal his will for you. When you're struggling with decision, God says, find that anywhere where God promised something to somebody else in the Bible, you can take the same promise for yourself. So God's promise is in the word of God. And how do we receive that? And how do we gain that faith? It says, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Amen.